Opel has been making cars in Rüsselsheim near Frankfurt for over a century. The company, which has weathered a number of crises, recently underwent major restructuring. Today, the plant is one of the most modern worldwide. More than 17,000 workers are employed here, and suppliers provide thousands more jobs. Now, they all fear redundancy.
It's never been this bad before. We've gone through rough times in the past, but we always managed to work our way out. But now there's little we can do. We basically got drawn in, and I think it's the same across the entire car industry. And now we have to find some way to get out.
What's next?
What do you mean? Opel is still up and running.
But you run out of money.
What do you mean, run out of money? We're still getting paid. And we're still working Saturdays and Sundays, so something can't be right.
So why the anxiety?
People aren't panicking. Maybe the people at the top are, but we don't have too much to do with them. We're working weekends and we have a new model. To be honest, we can't complain right now.
The new model, the Insignia, is due to hit showrooms in the coming days. It's a family car that's already been voted 2009's European Car of the Year. The Insignia is a glimmer of hope on the horizon for Opel. But the car maker's parent company, the US giant General Motors, is rumored to be facing insolvency. GM has pledged Opel billions in investments, and the German subsidiary needs the money to keep operations running. City officials in Rüsselsheim, including the mayor, are frustrated by the situation.
It's
highly ironic that on the day the new Opel Insignia is declared European Car of the Year, the company is thrust into danger, because the parent company in the United States is in difficulties. We have a new model, the order books are full, and there'll probably be extra shifts in the coming days and weeks. And then bad news from the United States. It just doesn't make sense.
Dann schlechte Direktiven aus USA. Das passt nicht zusammen.
The entire region's economy is tied to the auto industry. Rüsselsheim is home to some 60,000 people, and all of them know someone who works for Opel.
My father works for Opel.
And what's the mood like at home?
It's okay. He's 50, and if he really does lose his job next year, he's already said he'll emigrate to Thailand.
How about you?
I have relatives who work for Opel. For them, the mood at home isn't too good. We're all just hoping somehow that everything will work out in the end.
Can you imagine Rüsselsheim without Opel?
That's something that will never happen. You have to keep positive.
The company's founder, Adam Opel, would probably roll over in his grave and demand that his factories sever ties from their American parent company. If it weren't for General Motors, Opel would probably be in better shape.